So, this is another video. I'm online again. And let's work! I was working the other day with some new filter types. New custom filters. So, let me show you something. If you download the beta version, just be sure to download also the extra files. Let me show you something here. So I was working with the custom filter, and I added some extra filter types here. So, just testing out one of the filters. Let's try the last one.
Thank you.
Okay, just testing out a few things. One thing I have to test out here. Gesundheit! My wife is sneezing. It is not showing which one is loaded here, so let's say I loaded one that has a very long name. I can't see it, so I have to fix that. Because here it does show the loaded one. Okay, so let's add the other option. What kind of custom filter? Great, the let's see. No, where is the variable that tells me what's the last file loaded? What's the filter file? Okay, here the whole list is constructed. Filter file list. Lisbon used. Okay, let me check something out here, because I remember I created an option around here, I think. Oh, this is the option. Maybe we can use that instead. You'll see what's going on. That should do the trick. Okay, it's not working the way I want, so let me check why. Okie dokie. Well, because this is something else. Okay. I see the problem. Actually have to add these in another place. Let me remind where is the place. Here, but there are so many things I have to remind. Let's see. Where is this being constructed? This is the place where it gets constructed. Here. Okay, so I have to add it here. No big deal. So let me copy this up. See if this is right. Looks right. Okay. Shows right in here. Just have to update the text there. No big deal. Okay, I just have to update there. So I need to find another of those guys. Where else is being done that? Here. Okay, that should do the trick. Going to take a longer time. Takes a long time to compile, but it's doing okay. Here we go. Okay. Just some silly small thing, but it does help out. So, okay, we have now the extra options which we can use to construct new filter types, and also on effects also have new options. Let's see if it works as well. Okay, it's working. So let me try another file here. Filters. So I'm going to use this one. Let's call this stereo low pass inverted. Because what I'm going to do here, just keep the same file, but I'm going to invert the frequency. And add the stereo field. This should, in theory, give me a nice stereo effect. Let's see. Okay, it's not working the way I want, so let's check out why. Seem to be working the way I want. In theory, it's right. Let me check something out. Stereo is what I want in there. Put left and put right. Unless my stereo is not working and filter correctly. So let me try. Now the stereo is working. This guy is not working the way I want. Ah, of course, I always forget. 2.0. It's like this. There's a reason for this to be like this. Because it's reaching zero, of course. Okay, this should fix the problem. It's not very useful, to be honest. Okay, so what I have done here, I created a stereo path on the custom filter, and that's pretty much it. So the custom filters now have way much more options. Let me think what else. Okay, this is done. Just thinking of something here. Where's my filters? Okay. I am making multiplying by itself, so it makes to go logarithmic or exponential. I was confused both options, but should be one of those. Okay. Let me think on something, just be right back. So, there is a problem that I'm having. Let me see if I can check this out. At some point I have to create some examples of all of this. Let's see the problem. Sample player. This is a sine wave farm. It is perfectly looped. Thank you. some problems there. Why is doing that? Can't reproduce the problem anymore. Perhaps. Let's take a look. It's perfectly looped. What's going on? It's actually rather simple. And yet a pain in the ass to fix, but let's go there. Sample player. On the sample player we have the interpolation. Let me see where this is happening. Here's the problem. This is not correct. There I have to do two ifs. the hell? There's a problem there that I have to fix, but let's try this first. But there are two problems that I'm seeing. There's another problem with the envelope. I have to add. This is very hard to fine tune this one. Shift does nothing, right click does nothing. Okay, so the interpolation. Zero is. It's correct now. I don't know what I was thinking when I created this one. Let me expose this a bit, because condensing the code just make it look easier to look to see, but then it looks bad. Sometimes you have to write things in an easier way to understand, otherwise you get lost. It's very easy to get lost. Especially when you're dealing with monster code like Vuzix Station is. And it is a monster code. But there's a lot of things involved. Am I forcing mine? Or just forcing mine? Forgetting that. And I just hope that this gets in line correctly. There is a place to invoke that, let me check. Not here. Want to worry about that for now. So which position is lower than zero? Use zero. Now I have to create an option to check if the loops there are two options here, if loop and higher than zero is a looped sound, otherwise it's not a looped sound, so it's a different code then. Which position is over the size of the whole thing? -1. It's okay. -1, otherwise is 0. Oh, I see. I'm doing this the wrong way. Actually, no, that was right. Okay, that should work much better, especially for one-shot sounds. O que vocês estão aprontando? Is the next data? Oh, of course. That's why I created a macro. Of course. Okay, so how am I going to handle that? Have to create two. I can use void. No. Let's create two times that's in 16. Don't know any other way to create these in. I'm pretty sure that there is another way, I just don't know right now. I'm just going to duplicate the function. Just for the sake of having different values, I'm going to create 32 bits and 16 bits. Is 32 here is 16. Okay. Thank you. Okay, this is working much better now. Try it for other sounds. Nice to see you here again. I'm just fine. I'm just fixing some things up on the interpolation code. Already found a problem. And I'm trying to fix that. Well, I'm going to fix that. So I'm just for now trying. And I have to take a look at my math again because I don't think it's right. And I got a present from my sister. My sister gave me the monkey. My wife hates it. It's a monkey. It's a monkey. With LEDs. Okay, enough of the monkey. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the problem you were talking about. So, okay, let me test something else here. I doubt that's a problem, but let's use 16-bit memory. It has the same code, so. By the way, there are some new filters now. I was playing around with the filters early. So you can already download that. It's on the download area. So we have a few new filter types. So if you add the custom filter, there's the special filters here. You can see here on this list. Yes, sure, I remember you. Of course, man. I'm just a bit slow today, just that, but I'm working. And those new filter types are very good, man. You really have to try that out. And I'm just working now on the loop problem. I'm taking a look at my code. I did find a problem already, because the interpolation I'm using is a 4-point interpolation, so I use the sample, previous samples, and the next one and two samples. So there's a few problems that I forgot to check out, but I'm doing right now. Okay, I already see one problem here, so let me put this inside the loop, because I have to be careful with a few things when it comes to looped sounds. Loop start. Lower than zero has to be the loop start. Start loop. Offset. Let's see. Man, it's very hot today. Yesterday we had like 40 degrees in some areas, and in some cities it was up to 47. Today is not so bad, it's 32 Celsius. So it's not that bad, but it's still very hot. Okay, this is a weird file. Let me try something else here. Carefully look at this. But I want to check. When the WAV files gets loaded. No, actually I can look here. It sounds loop start zero loop in 599. Okay, what's going on here? Okay. Oh yes, I will fix this for sure. I just have to find where I'm doing things the wrong way. For now I'm going to disable this just so I know I'm working on the right code. Just for sanity check. Because I remember working on the draw wave oscillator, and there was some problems there, and I wasn't able to fix it. Let me take a look at the draw wave oscillator again, and I'm going to this one is looping very well. Let me see. It's very good. actually a sample. Yes, I know, but there are two problems actually. That's why I'm trying this one. But then I'm going to take a look at the other thing. So sunsets, okay. This is a very large sample. Very soft. This is very hard to listen because that's why I'm trying this one. Here, this is a problem already. So I'm going to try to not my mic. Okay. The problem is that I know what the problem is. I have to lower the output because I'm sampling with another card. Was started, so let me see. Where is my Fido guy here? My sound mixer. Because I'm using another card, so. Not even showing here. Oh crap. Yes, yeah, I know. Just have to find what device I'm using because I have three sound cards here. Oh, it's outputting from the Behringer. And then it gets input on another card. Recording devices, lining. How can I adjust the level? It's already on level 0. What the heck? Oh, it's not that. So this one. I want to try level 62. Man, you tell me if it's better. Let me know if it's distorting less now. I didn't know about that, sorry. Okay, now the noise gate is closing up. I have to adjust. No, thank you, man, because if people don't tell me things, I just don't know about it. Noise suppression, noise gate. Let's see, it's better now. Okay. So, live and learn, my friend. I'm doing something wrong here, so let me take a look at the drawable oscillator because that code is just gold. It's just perfect. Thank you. Okay, what's going on here? Some goes. I'll have to check it out. Oh, this is the bloody cold. It's a different cold. Okay, so let me first see if I can. This is the interpolation code. Let me see how close. I don't remember where I got the other code. Crap. 2.5. Samples 1, like samples 0. The code is different. Very different. Okay. Let me double check my interpolation samples here. I have to remember. Yeah, in the worst case scenario, I'm just going to use that code instead, because it just works sometimes. Sometimes you just have to use what is already working. But I just want to take a look here in the code. So the loop is higher than 0, loop end. Okay, so it's using this guy here. For that case at least. What's going on here? What's this in there? If the position minus 1, 0. Ah, here's already found an error. It has to go the loop end because it's looped. My plus 1. It's not higher than the loop end. Otherwise, it goes to the loop start. Okay, let's hear this baby. I need to learn a few new things on C++ because I'm going to spend a minute. Let me take a look again. This one, 0. Let's loop it. That's one crazy math. Maybe the interpolation is not correct in here. Let me take a look. I was working side off. Just for the sake of testing, I'm going to copy this to Scalar. Scalar is a SSC code that processes just one number instead of four numbers. So I just go and replace PS with SS. Use all that. Okay. So it's samples 1 with samples. Phase of him face. It's doing two times here, just the one. So here is fraction. Thank you. I did bad. So my father got an iPad. Whoops. Whoops, it is. Just a minute. Oh, of course. Not like this. Have to divide it for just for the sake. Oh man, if it's not one thing, it's another. hear this. The same crap. Ah, that sucks. Let me just double check this. Go get the samples. Point 3. Let's double check this again. Correct now. So the problem is not in here. Let me take a look at something else. I'm just checking a few things out here, just to be sure that's double position. Rate, fraction rate is double. It means okay, that's all correct. Just to be sure it's not doing something crazy here. I'm just going to do a quick linear interpolation here, just to check things out. Then I can start moving on the code and check what is going on. And then I can take a look at the draw labels later and see what's happening there. Something very strange going on. What am I doing wrong? I'm not going to bother with these guys here, I'm just going to bother with the position 1, That's the current position and position 2. Okay. It's correct. Let me see if I'm not doing this. No, getting the operation is correct. So that's not a problem, but just in case. Let me check the process next as well. Reverse, ping pong, and forward. Okay, that's not a problem. Oh man. Is acting very strange, but just in case. I don't understand. Something so simple to fail so bad. Unless the offset is not right. But it's not that. Where is the other offset? Come on, man. What's going on? This loop ends 599. Problem there. Me brain is not working. That's just crazy talk. I want to take a look at the drawway with Slater code again, just in case, because it's just not working for some reason. Okay, so let's see. Where is it? Get some votes. Let me take a closer look at this. This seems correct, but there is one small problem here. It's lower than zero. It's the same thing as this one. And I have to check the loop start. Ah, much better to do wrong now. This guy. And it's going to rain again. Rain. That's just weird. Let's try this again. I have to take a look again. This guy here. If this is correct, let me check. This guy here. Okay, he's plus one. Well, I don't know what else could be happening. Let me check the file again. There's a tree. So, no insulator. There's a tree. This works perfectly. Okay, I found the problem. It's a silly little problem. Guess I can just go ahead and lower than minus. That's the culprit. Something so simple, but yet so dangerous. Not too loud. It's clicking here. A bit strange. Okay. Let me see what's going on with this guy. Where does where do I compute the next delta? It is loop size plus one. Okay, that's something that's not good. G3. This is correct. This one, okay. Great. I'm missing here. I'm almost there. Let's hear this working now. But at least I found some other issues on the code. I didn't just fix that. Okay, let me record the volume here so I can play some chords. Too loud. I know. Almost done. Almost done. We are getting there. So let me check this code. Does this just work? I just can reuse that one. Then I have to add some pieces and bits that are missing. Well, this is good news. This is great news. Oh, good, my friend. Give me a while to do this, but and at least I understand what's going on, what I did wrong, that's very important. And oops. So let's check things out here. Just double check. If the position is lower than zero, but the loop start is higher than zero, there's a zero sum, otherwise we have to go to the loop end. Thanks, man. I sure try. I should try my best. And this should work as well. This is for one shot samples. One shot samples, zero is zero. And as long as it's inside the sample data, otherwise it's zero as well. Okay, so this is good. This is good. I'm just thinking. Then thanks for telling me, man, because if I don't know, if people don't tell me things, it's very hard to fix. When I say hard, it's impossible. How do I create a macro for this without creating an incredible, strange piece of code? I really need to learn a few new methods of, because I don't know how to create templates. Just let me play around with the internet a bit here, and I'm going to find out about C++ templates, because this is just dumb. I'm just copying the same function. Template function. Maybe it's not so hard to do. just said that I never done this before. I know some people are going to say, what? You've been programming for 20 years, you're considered a guru of coding, and you don't know how to do that. Yeah, I don't know how to do that. Okay, let's see here. Is this so simple? Is this gonna work? I sure hope so. Oh man, which is that simple. Looks like I learned something new. Let's see if it compiles. Brother. Yeah, looks good so far. So let's try it out. Let's load a 16 bits memory. Yeah, it works. Just a minute, guys. I'm going to turn off the AC. Cookies! Cookie time. My wife is going to kill me. Did I learn something new today?
Yes, sir. I did.
The monkey. I don't know if you can see the monkey. It's too dark to see. Ah, I hate this camera. It's a keychain, actually. I already drank some Pepsi today, and it has caffeine. Okay, just let me double check this, but it looks good. Yeah, this looks good. I'm just going to recompile just in case. And then I'm going to load some other files to see what's going on. Oh yeah, it's good. I'm testing the one-shot file shoot to be sure it's all good. Ah, my nose! Oh yeah. All good. There is another thing I want to try out. Let me compile this so you can test out too. I'm just going to compile the Vuzix Station version, then upload, then you can download. These cookies are very good, but they're very dry. I have to get some water next. Oh, Vuzix support. What's going on? There's a lot of people that purchased it like 4 years ago and wanted to re-download. Almost every day I get an email asking me how can I re-download the program. And one guy was using version 3 and got mad at me because I didn't have version 3 anymore online. And I said, but I can't keep all the single versions online. It's too much space. And he was mad, but I managed to get the files for him. It's just impressive on how many people that don't do backups of their files. Just do a backup. It's important. He just let me quickly. Ah, yeah, and then complain. Quickly do a test with the 64-bit version, just in case. Okay, it's working. Yeah, that's simple. Let me compress these files. Going to call this beta92b because I haven't changed the version name. So I'm opening another window here and I'm going to upload the file there. So these are all my server files. No, I actually looked at the Dual Wave Oscillator code to check how I did there and to find what was the problem. Because I can't just reuse the same code because the sample player, let's say the Dual Wave Oscillator is a file that's always looped. The loops start from 0 to 599, where the sample player can be anything. Can be a non-looped file, it can be a file that's looped midway through the end. So that way I have to add some other type of math functions. So I fixed the existing one and also took a look at the Dual Wave Oscillator just to be sure I didn't miss anything and improve it, especially for. Hey Marvik, nice to see you again here and thanks for hosting me. I was just talking with Costas about some changes I did today on the sample player. I fixed some very important things on the sample player. There was some noises on the sound that was driving me nuts, and also Costas was getting almost losing his mind for this noise. And I'm just uploading the files now. You can download there, Costas. It's just you are on Windows, right? If you're on Mac, you have to tell me, because I don't remember if you're on Windows or Mac. I uploaded the Windows 92B beta version. So the noise is gone now. It's very clean, because it was driving me nuts, because this file here, this sound, as soon as you get off center, you can hear some looping sound, some really bad sound, and now it's very clean. I fixed the whole interpolation code on the Vuzix station, and also it's going to reflect. Morvik, if you are on Windows, you can get the 92B beta for Vuzix Station version 8 on Windows. Ah, sorry guys, my nose started to act up because of the air conditioner, the AC. And yeah, now it sounds much better. I was doing some tests with other files too, and it's just doing much better. It's very clean now. Oh, you're on Mac. I'm going to compile the Mac files in a minute, so just give me an hour, because I want to fix something else here on the ADSR mode for the amplitude envelope. Now it's good. Now it's very good. Before it was just crap. But it happens. But you have to understand, the noise started on the beta version, so the previous version should be okay, but I did improve, because this new version now has a 4-point interpolation that's called Hermit interpolation, like the frog, I guess. Hermit the frog. No, I don't think that it speaks like that. And I also created some new filter types, Morvik. These I think you're going to like, at least Coast is very happy about it. So on the custom filter, now you have those new filter types here. Let me run some tests here. A bit loud. Sorry guys, I'm just trying something out here. Thank you. Reverb and flanger filter? How that works? I have no idea. Oh, I also improved the carpool strong. Okay, I don't know how that works, but I'm going to check out then. I think there's a flanger effect on the... Where are my... Oh, the VST effect. Maybe the flanger, I think there's one. No, there's no one. There's no flanger effect here! What if 2-0? Well, that's kind of a flanger. Let me lower the volume a bit. What's the difference of a flanger and a 2-0 flanger? Yes, I know. I'm trying to add as many stuff I can, but at least now we have the custom effect. We didn't have that before. The custom effect is going to open up several new options. You can check the loop recorder especially. Here, let me see. Custom delay. At least there are a few new options there to play around with. Yes, there's always room for improvement. Oh no! Another hand! That's my wife. She hates the monkey. Stop! Okay. So... Yes, well, maybe you can give me some ideas on how to improve that. I know it's not the best one, but at least it's a start, I would say. I'm not going to go Sega and say it's better than nothing. No, it's not Sega. It's the guys that created the new game. Amazing 9, I think. What's the name of the new game? They say, oh, it's good enough, better than nothing. Yeah, who cares? Okay, what I was working on... is the multi-line envelope. What is the multi-line envelope again? Multi-line envelope. But I was hoping that I could do some fine tuning when we are on the ADSR mode. So let's see here, ADSR. This one. mouse up. Where's the mouse drag? Oh, like opening a new window. Okay, I can check that options to open a new window. Then that way you can always having cheating, I guess. I don't know if that's possible with the interface, but I can check that. Not saying no. Yeah, I know, I didn't add any icons because to be able to do it very quickly. Well, the colors you can change on the skin itself. It's a bit of a pain to change, I know, but you can do that there. But let me fix this, and while I do that, you can write something up to me, and then I'm going to see if it's possible to change or not. Where's my other window? Oh, I closed it. Okay, so let me open again. There. Drag. So let me remind, put the mouse down. Oh crap, I need to copy this. Oh man, post the video link if you can. I don't know if it has some copyrights of your own work, but oh, there you go. Let me open this on my computer here, then we can watch. New window. Actually, I can change it. That's the camera. That's the display. Window capture. That's the one. Sound. Where is that? It's small.
Sound.
Oh, headphones. Can I open this bigger? Oh yeah, very nice, man. Let me see why it's... Just let this YouTube stream it. I don't know why it's so slow. Just a minute. Oh, it's dropping frames. Crap. It's streaming now. Okay, now I can play it. Oh man, let me turn. My internet is crap. I don't know what does that. Jeez. What a piece of junk. And the worst thing is that I couldn't get the new internet. It didn't work. I'm going to let it stream a little bit more as I work my way out of here. My way around things here. Okay, let me see where I'm adding this. So it's going to be. As soon as it loads up the entire thing, then I can stream it. Yes, please, please do. I have 5. But it's a very bad company. I was trying another company and it didn't work out. Okay, so when the mouse is down, I have to compute the previous node data. Okay, this is what I need. So move, where's the grab, drag. See how it's looking up, man. It's still streaming. Impressive, impressive. Distance. It's the thing. You understand what I'm talking about in just a minute. There's no shift. Oh well. So let's see if this is going to work now. Come on, internet, work. Very good, man. Come on, don't stream now. Internet. That sucks. Sorry guys, the internet is just not behaving. The problem is not the stream itself, it's something else, I don't know. What I'm doing here. Okay, now it's working. I can add a bit more precision. 0001. Let's see if it loads up. No, it's still loading. Nah. So what I'm doing here, I'm just adding fine precision to the envelope when you are on ADSR mode. Let me show something here. Very fine tuning. Okay. I was thinking another thing that I think. Thank you. Okay, let me take a look. Open new window. Endless wave build. Oh yes, I was thinking on something like that a while ago, but it's a lot of work. Let me bookmark this page. I was hoping to do something like the loop point, something like that. So I do have my eyes on that. Let me watch a bit of the video again. And it's still streaming! Jeez. Marvik, this is very impressive. How did you create this video? Oh, okay. Okay, my internet is still acting up. That's me. Well, the X fade, I was already thinking on an option for the X fade, but I was too lazy to do one. Guys, just giving me 10 minutes. I'm going to grab some water, then I'm going to think about the other things you guys are talking about. Just a minute.